Hello everybody, today we are going to see some theorems which are depend on the concept angles subtended by a chord. Okay, in the last period we have seen activity, okay, which was related to angles subtended by a chord. Now we are going to see some theorems. From that, first theorem is theorem number 1, equal chords of a circle subtend equal angle at the center. Okay, once again see. Equal chords of a circle subtend equal angle at the center. Okay, here circle is given center O, with center O, and PQ and SR are the chords which are equal. Okay, PQ and SR are the chords which are equal. The length of PQ and length of SR is same. So first, in circle COR. COR, C is for circle. Okay, CO, O, O is the center of the circle and R is the radius. Okay, OR, PQ, chord PQ, chord PQ is equal to chord SR or RS. Okay, this is given. Chord PQ and chord RS is given. Okay, so in circle, or we can write COR, that is also enough. Okay, so this is given, chord PQ and chord SR is equal. What is given? Equal chords of a circle subtend equal angle at the center. At the center. Okay, so when we will join this, PO, this, okay, subtend equal angle at the center, means what we have to prove here? We have to prove, POQ, angle POQ is equal to angle SROS, ROS, okay, POQ, this angle is equal to ROS, okay, two angles are equal, that we need to prove, understood? So now, first we will think about how we can give this proof. See here, two triangles are formed. We have seen how to prove congruent, triangles congruent, okay. So now, if we will prove both the triangles are congruent, then easily we can say POQ is equal to SOR by CPCT, okay. So first we need to think about that. So here see, about these two triangles, PO, we can say PO is equal to OR or OS, because PO is also radius and OR is also radius, OS is also radius and OQ is also radius. Okay, so all the radii of the same circle are always equal. So we can say PO is equal to RO. PO is equal to RO. Secondly, we can say OQ is equal to OS. Actually, this all the four PO, OS, OR and OQ, all are same. Understood? But to prove both the triangles are congruent, we will choose one pair, PO and OR. So I am saying here, in proof, in triangle POQ and triangle ROS, PO is equal to RO. PO is equal to RO. Okay. Then we can say here, QO or OQ is equal to OS. OQ is equal to OS. OQ and OS are equal. Okay. This is also radius. So what is the reason of this? Radii of the same circle. Radii of the same circle are always equal. Okay. And third thing, we can use PQ is equal to SR, which is given. Okay, here it is given in the statement, equal chords of a circle. So we can use that PQ is equal to SR. Okay, so this we can write reason here given. Okay, so here we have three sides of triangle POQ are equal to the three sides of triangle ROS. Okay, so by side means SSS criteria, we can say both the triangles are congruent. So here we can write triangle POQ congruent triangle ROS by SSS congruency criteria or by SSS condition. Okay, so now here we have given proof. Both the triangles, triangle POQ and triangle ROAS are congruent. Okay, if both the triangles are congruent, then what is our target? What we have to prove here? Angle POQ is equal to angle ROAS, and these are the corresponding angle. This is the corresponding, this pair is the corresponding angle pair. So here we can say POQ is equal to ROS. Angle POQ is equal to angle ROS. What is the reason for this? Bicipicity. Corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so here reasons are important. We need to write reason for each and every step in theorem. Okay, so here POQ is equal to ROS. So here we can say equal chords of a circle subtend equal angle at the center. Okay, so this property we are going to use while doing sums. Okay. Okay, so see here our second theorem is, if the angle subtended by the chord, by the two chords at the center of a circle are equal, then the chords are equal. Okay, before this it was given that chords are equal, then we have to prove that angles subtended at the center are equal. But now what is given? Angles subtended by this chord at the center are equal, and we have to prove chords are same or equal. Okay, means this is the converse of the first theorem. Second theorem is the converse of the first theorem. Okay, so this is also very easy proof. Easily we can give the solution or proof for this. So see here, given, what is given? Given, if the angle subtended by the two chords at the center of a circle, okay, in circle C O R, O is the center, R is the radius. Okay, what is given? PQ and RS are the chords, of this circle. Okay, two chords of the circle. Okay, which are not equal, that is not given, that we have to prove. So that we will not mention in the given. Okay, now what is given? See, if the angles subtended by the two chords at the center of a circle are equal, angle subtended at the center means this angle POQ is equal to ROS, that is given. Okay, so here we can take that angle POQ is equal to angle ROS. ROS, okay, angles are equal, then given over, then we can say here to prove, what we have to prove? Then the chords are equal. So here we have to prove PQ, chord PQ, is equal to chord RS. Chord PQ is equal to chord RS. Okay, that we need to prove. That is also very simple. Easily we can understand from this. See, we can say PO is equal to OR because radii of the same circle. First, we will think about two triangles, POQ and ROS. In both the triangles, we can say PO is equal to RO, then QO is equal to SO, and this POQ is equal to SOR. Okay, which is given, means by side angle side, both the triangles are congruent. If triangles are congruent, then PQ and SR are equal, which are the corresponding sides of congruent triangle and which are the chords of the circle. Okay, so this is also very simple proof. So see carefully here, in proof we can write here PO in triangle, first in triangle POQ and triangle ROS, PO is equal to RO, PO is equal to RO, then QO is equal to SO, QO is equal to SO. Okay, this is the reason, radii of the same circle, okay. Then next thing, POQ is equal to ROS, angle POQ is equal to angle ROS. Okay, why these two angles are equal? Because it is given. Okay, so here we will write reason given. Okay, so two sides and subtended angle are equal to the two sides and subtended angle of the corresponding triangle. then the triangles are congruent. So with the help of these three things we can say triangle POQ is congruent triangle ROS by side angle side. Only here criteria is different, otherwise procedure is same. Okay, so if triangles are congruent then we can say PQ is equal to RS. PQ, so chord PQ is equal to, or first we will say initially PQ is the side, so PQ is equal to RS, okay, by CPCT. Okay, or finally again one more step we can add, we can write chord PQ is equal to chord RS. We are talking about this triangle, so PQ and RS are equal, so finally we can say chord PQ is equal to chord RS. Okay, so see our next theorem, theorem number 3. The perpendicular from the center of a circle bisects the chord. Okay, what is given? The perpendicular from the center of a circle bisects the chord. Okay, so here figure is given. What actually we are going to do, or what we need to do, that we will see first. First we need to think about the answer and then we need to bring on the paper. Okay, then only we can reach to the destination. So see carefully, the perpendicular from the center of circle, this is O is the center of circle. Okay, perpendicular from the center of circle bisects the chord. PQ is the chord. Okay, it bisects the chord means what we need to prove here, PL and LQ are equal. That is our target. Okay, so first given things. So in given, the perpendicular from the OL is perpendicular in circle in COR, circle radius R. We need to use that OL. OL is perpendicular to chord PQ. Perpendicular to chord PQ. Okay. So we need to prove that. To prove, the center of circle bisect the chord means PL. PL is equal to QL. This we need to prove. Okay, so this is also very simple proof, but we need to do some construction. We need to join this PQ, PO and Q. That is the construction. So here we will join this okay, so join OP construction, we need to mention join OP, OP and OQ, join OP and OQ. Okay, so now when you will join this, that time you will get two triangles. Okay, so we need to prove both the triangles are congruent. Okay, so first we will think how we can give this proof. So see here, about these two triangles, triangle OPL and triangle OQL. So here we will take, that is in proof, in triangle OPL, OPL and triangle OQL. Okay, which things are easily we can get, that we will see. OP and OQ are equal. OP and OQ are equal. First thing is both the triangles are right angle. That we need to think. Then second thing, OP and OQ are equal. Okay, and third thing is OL is common. OL is the common side for both the triangles. So we need to think about criteria now. Okay, first both the triangles are right angles, so we can think about RHS criteria or other criteria also we can use here, but we need to think about that. So here first we will think about RHS criteria, because right angle triangles, both the triangles are right angle, then hypotenuse are equal. What is the condition of RHS criteria? One, both angles should be right angle, then hypotenuse should be equal and any one leg should be equal. So all the conditions are satisfying by this figure. So see here, both the triangles are right angle. Okay, so here we will mention that angle OLP, OLP is equal to angle OLQ, okay, each 90 degree. So both the triangles are right angle triangle. Then OP is equal to OQ, OP is equal to OQ, So radii of the same circle. Radii of the same circle are always equal. Okay, these two are the radius, radii of the same circle, but these are the hypotenuse for these two triangles and that are equal. So OP and OQ are equal, then we can say OL is equal to OL because that is the common side for both the triangles. So here we can say OL is equal to OL, that is common side for both the triangles. So see, both the triangles are right angle, from that one angle is 90 degree, hypotenuse are equal and one leg of both the triangles are equal, which is common here. So these three things are satisfying RHS criteria. Okay, so here we can say triangle OPL congruent triangle OQL by RHS condition. Okay, if triangles are congruent, both the triangles are congruent, then we can say PL is equal to QL because these are the corresponding sides. So easily we can say here, so PL is equal to QL by CPCP, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay, so what we are going to use, this C. The perpendicular from the center of a circle bisects the chord, means this is the perpendicular. Okay, so it bisects the chord, means next time whenever sum will come, that time with the help of this reason or this statement, we can use directly PL is equal to QL. These are the evidences which we will refer, but directly the output we will use to solve the examples. Okay. See here, theorem number 4 is, the line joining the center of a circle to the midpoint of a chord is perpendicular to the chord. Okay. The line joining the center of a circle, to the midpoint of chord, means here about this figure, M is the midpoint of PQ, chord PQ. So definitely one thing we got here, that is PM and QM are equal. Okay. So what is given? The line joining the center of a circle to the midpoint of a chord, is perpendicular to the chord. Means here we need to prove that OM is perpendicular to the PQ. OM and PQ are perpendicular. That we need to prove. Okay. So see here. First, we will mention given things. Okay, the line joining the center of a circle to the midpoint of a chord. Okay, so in COR, okay, OM, M is the midpoint of PQ, chord PQ. M is the midpoint of chord PQ. Okay, so OM is the line which is joining to the midpoint of PQ. Okay. Now, what we have to prove? To prove OM is perpendicular, to chord PQ. M is the midpoint, of PQ. So here we can say in given PM is equal to QM. This is given. And we have to prove that OM is perpendicular to the PQ. This is our target. So we need to do some construction, that is same construction, that is we need to join OP and OQ. Okay, so join OP and OQ. So construction, join OP and OQ. Okay, so two triangles are formed here when you will join this OP and OQ, which are the radii of the same circle. Okay, so that also we are going to use. So now proof. In proof, first we will take two triangles, triangle OPM in triangle OPM and triangle OQM. Okay, what is given here? OP is equal to OQ. Because radii of the same circle. radii of the same circle. OP and OQ are equal. Then OM is equal to OM because common. So OM is equal to OM, common side. Common side for both the triangles. And third thing is PM is equal to QM. PM and QM, which is given because M is the midpoint. So we can write here PM is equal to QM. Okay. M is the midpoint of PQ. M is the midpoint of PQ. M is the midpoint of PQ. Okay. So PM is equal to QM. So now by side, three sides. So triangle OPM are equal to the three sides of triangle OQM. So by side, we can say triangle OPM congruent triangle OQM by side SSS condition. Okay. So here our half answer completed. Still, what is our target? OM perpendicular to PQ, that we need to show. Now here we have given proof. Both the triangles are congruent. So if triangles are congruent, so we can see here angle OMP is equal to angle OMQ by CPCT. Okay. So OMP means this angle, corresponding angle. This angle is equal to this. Still, we have not given proof OM is perpendicular to PQ. How to show OM is perpendicular to PQ? If angle OMP is 90 degree or angle OMQ is 90 degree, that time we can say OM is perpendicular to PQ. But still we have not given that. So we need to think about that. Now here what we have told? OMP is equal to OMQ. Okay, this much we have given. Now we know that these two angles are forming linear pair. Linear pair means what? Sum of both the angles will be 180 degree. So that reference we are going to use. This angle is equal to this. But now what we are going to do? Angle OMP plus angle OMQ is equal to 180 degree, forming linear pair. But these two angles, this angle is equal to this. Why? Here we have told angle OMP is equal to angle OMQ. These angles are equal. So we can replace this angle by this or this angle by this. Okay, so I am doing here angle OMP plus this I am replacing by this. Angle OMP is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so here we can, suppose I will say here this is first one. So I can say here from 1. Now OMP plus OMP, 2 times angle OMP is equal to 180 degree. So angle OMP is equal to 180 divided by 2 is 90 degree. Angle OMP is 90 degree. So this is OMP is 90 degree. This 90 degree means that also 90 degree because both the angles are same. Okay. So here now we can say OM is perpendicular to PQ. So OM is perpendicular to PQ. Hence the proof. Okay. So this is very simple proof. Today we have seen 4 theorems. So these theorems and properties which are coming from these theorems, that those properties are very much important because this year, next year in class 11, 12 also we need to use this reference. Okay. So see here, we are going to see one example which is depend on the theorems. Just now we have seen those properties we are going to use here. Okay. So see here carefully, AB and CD are two parallel chords of a circle which are on opposite sides of the center such that AB is equal to 10 cm, CD is equal to 24 cm and the distance between AB and CD is 17 cm. Find the radius of the circle. Okay, so here circle is given, center we will say O. Okay, once again see, AB and CD are two parallel chords, that is important thing. AB and CD are parallel chords of a circle which are opposite sides of the center. This is the center and this is upside and this is downside, means opposite side of the center. Okay, so here sometimes example can come on the same side of the center, means AB and CD are on the this side or that side, like that also example can come. So AB is equal to 10 centimeter, CD is equal to 24 centimeter, CD is equal to 24 centimeter. This is now what is given, and the distance between AB and CD is 17 centimeter. The distance between this is 17 centimeter. So suppose I will join this point, I will join this, okay, I will join this, then I will get there 2 points. This is the center O, okay, and this I will say P, this is I am saying P, and this is Q. This is 10 centimeter. AB is given 10, CD is given 24 centimeter. Okay, and the distance between P, PQ, this distance is given, what is the distance? 17 centimeter. Okay, 17 centimeter is given, whole distance. Now AB and CD 17 centimeter, find the radius of the circle. We have to find out a radius of this circle. Okay, so see here carefully, this will we will solve as a theorem, because we need to mention given things, whatever given things are there, that we will take here. So given, it is not necessary to every time to take given, directly also we can use. Okay, so here I am taking. Now given, what is given? AB and CD are the chords of circle. Of circle, that is COR. Okay, AB is parallel to CD. AB and CD are parallel, that is important thing. Okay, now what is given? AB is equal to 10 centimeter. AB is equal to 10 centimeter. CD is equal to 24 centimeter. Okay, and PQ, this distance PQ, is equal to 17 centimeter. PQ is what? The distance between two parallel chords which are given. Distance between chords is 17 centimeter. Okay. So now PQ is given 17 centimeter and AB and CD 70 centimeter. Find the radius of the circle. Here we have to find out the radius of the circle. So to prove of radius R of the circle, to find radius, that is R of the circle. Okay, so to find out radius, we need to do some construction. So that is, we will join this O to point B. Okay, as well as we will join this here also. Okay, so now we have two triangles. Okay, triangle POB and triangle QOB, OD. Okay, so now construction we need to mention here. In construction we will write join OB and OD. Join OB and OD. Okay, so we have done that. This also construction we need to mention. Okay, take a perpendicular, OP perpendicular to AB, OP perpendicular to OB, and OQ perpendicular to CD. That we have done construction. But one property we can use here, just now we have seen a perpendicular drawn from the center of circle bisect the chord. Okay, perpendicular drawn from the center of circle bisect the chord. Okay, so OP is perpendicular to AB. So first we in main proof OP, first we will mention here OP is perpendicular to AB. So OP is perpendicular to AB, so we can say AP is equal to PB. AP and PB are equal. Okay, so PB is equal to, what is the length of PB? Here what is the reason we can give? Reason AP is equal to PB, because perpendicular drawn from the center bisects the chord. Okay, so AP is equal to PB. So this is the reason why AP and PB are equal. So OP is perpendicular to this. So AP is equal to PB. So I want to find out PB. Okay, let the radius, we will say R, and this is also R, because radius of the same circle are same. So PB is equal to, PB is equal to half of AB. PB is equal to half of AB, that is half of 10 centimeter. So that is 5 centimeter. So PB is equal to 5 centimeter. PB is equal to 5 centimeter. So this we have 5 centimeter. And this is 5 centimeter. This is R. Okay. Now we will think about CD. Okay. So CQ, OQ is perpendicular to CD. OQ is perpendicular to CD. OQ is perpendicular to CD, we have taken. And POQ are the collinears, collinear points. So OQ is perpendicular to CD. So we can say CQ is equal to DQ. CQ is equal to DQ with the help of same reason. Perpendicular drawn from the center of circle, bisect the chord. Okay. So here just I am taking perpendicular drawn from the center of circle. Center of circle bisects the chord. Okay, so CQ is equal to DQ. So suppose I want to find out DQ. DQ is equal to half of CD. DQ is equal to half of CQ is equal to DQ. DQ is equal to half of CD. So half of CD means what? Half into 24 centimeter. So it is 12 centimeter. 12 centimeter. DQ is equal to 12 centimeter. So this we have 12 centimeter. Now we will think about this. Now we will think about PQ. Okay. So this is perpendicular. This is also perpendicular. Now PQ. PQ is given 17 centimeter. PQ is equal to 17 centimeter. Okay. So suppose I will consider PO. PO x centimeter. Let the PO. PO is equal to x centimeter. So can you tell me what will be the length of QO? So QO is equal to PQ minus PO, that is 17 minus x. Okay, what this much only we can write. So this is 17 minus x. This is x. So now we have enough information. So now if you will observe these two, this is also right angle triangle and this is also right angle triangle, and we have to find out radius of the same circle. So here I am going to use Pythagoras property. In triangle POB by Pythagoras. Pythagoras theorem. So this is the right angle triangle, so this is the hypotenuse. So directly I am taking hypotenuse square, that is R square is equal to side square is x square plus second side is 5 square. Okay, so that is R square is equal to x square plus 25. So this I am saying this is first one. Now we will use the Pythagoras property in the second triangle, that is in triangle OQD by Pythagoras. Pythagoras property, that is OQ, here I am taking, that is OQ OD square. OD is the radius. So R square is equal to OQ square. OQ square, what is OQ? 17 minus X square plus QD. QD is 12 square. Okay, so here we need to use A minus B bracket square. So what is that? 17 square, that is 289. 17 square is 289. Plus x square, the product of these two and its twice, that is minus 34x plus 144. Okay, so 289 plus 144, what you will get? 289 plus 144. 433. Okay, 433. R square plus x square minus 34x. So R square is equal to this. So I am saying here this is second one. Okay, so here also we have r square and there also we have r square. So both the values we can equate because the radii of the same circle are equal. So from 1 and 2 we can say, from 1 and 2, x square plus 25 is equal to 433 plus x square minus 34x. So now here this x square and this x square we can cancel, because anyhow this is going to come this side and it will be negative. So plus x square and this side plus x square will be cancelled. So now 433 will come this side, or minus 34 I am taking this side, minus 34x is equal to 433 minus 25. Okay, so 34x is equal to 433 minus 25, so it will be 408. Okay, because 33 minus 25, it will be 8. So 408, x is equal to 408 divided by 34. So it will be 34 ones are 34, remains 6 and 8, 34 twos are, so 12 centimeter. X is equal to 12 centimeter. Okay, if x is 12 centimeter, what is the length of this? 17 minus 6, that is 17 minus 12. 17 minus 12 is 5 centimeter. So 12 plus 5, 17 centimeter. Okay, so we can put this, x is equal to 12 centimeter. This we can put in any equation. Okay, here I am taking that r square is equal to x square plus 5. So that I am now writing here. Put x is equal to 12 centimeter. X is equal to 12 centimeter. Put in equation 1. Okay, so equation 1 is r square is equal to x square plus 5 square is 25. X is 12 square plus 25. 12 square is 144 plus 25. 144 plus 25, 169 centimeter. R square is equal to 169 centimeter square. This here, so square, centimeter square, centimeter square. So is equal to 13 centimeter. R is equal to 13 centimeter. So radius of this circle is 13 centimeter. Understood? So this way we need to solve such type of problem. See carefully. Thank you very much.